It takes courage to break free from the shackles of social inequality. It takes enormous amounts of courage to believe that things can change. It takes a leader to fight these inequalities and establish a new social order. Jai Hind, everyone. On this Constitution Day, I, Cadet Shivani Pundir from 11 UK Girls Battalion, would like you to take a glimpse of the life of India's constitution framer, Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar was a profound leader, a powerful politician, powerful women emancipator, and a prolific writer. He was the 14th child of Ramji Maloji Sakpal, who was Sobedar in the Indian Army. Ambedkar was born into a poor, low Dalit caste family who were treated as untouchables and were subjected to socio-economic discrimination. Ambedkar faced the discrimination from his childhood onwards. In his school, the children like him were not allowed to sit inside the class and were required to sit on the gunny sack outside the class. They were not allowed to drink water with other children. The peon used to pour the water, and on days of his leave, the children like him have to do without drinking water. He later described this thing in his writings, "No peon, no water." Such discrimination shook Babasaheb, and he decided to uproot this evil. For this, he used a weapon named education. After being shifted to Mumbai, he became the only Dalit to get enrolled into Elphinstone High School, University of Bombay. He completed his bachelor's from the college and for further studies moved to USA. Under the guidance of Sayaji Rao Gaikwad, he was awarded with a scholarship that was designed to provide opportunities for the postgraduate education at the Columbia University. There, he was awarded with the number one scholar in the world. He completed his master's in political science, economics, history, and sociology. But this man did not stop here. He went to London School of Economics, completed his MSc, studied law, and got a doctorate degree. After this, he completed his thesis on the books on whose basis the Reserve Bank of India was established.